Academy. You couldn't even see them. Yeah. They're just some nobody from the reserve course who never had a talent to begin with. A nobody who forgot he was a nobody. That's all.
I really am nobody, then. You should have just left me alone. He's not wrong. He's not wrong. Private schools, am I right? Totally. To be fair, I never went to a private school.
I had a good education in public time.
Mm-hmm. Why? Why do I have to go through something like this?
Hajime.
Did something happen? Huh?
Hey, bastard!
That's not the time to zone out. Sorry, it's nothing.
I
really get it, but is it? Is that all?
I'm gonna do it!
As long as I don't beat the crap out of Monokuma, everything's gonna be solved. Is that what it means?
Hey.
Hey, just what the heck is Monokuma anyway? He's not part of the Future Foundation, right? If you say that, then what is the Future Foundation?
Jeez.
Even though Chiaki and Monomi are gone, the situation hasn't changed one bit, which means Future Foundation wasn't our enemy. It's the only thing I can think of.
You serious?
So they're not World Ender? Then we really were tricked by Monokuma?
However,
the Future Foundation's responsible for trapping us on this island, right? Regarding that matter, I believe Monomi never once denied that.
Damn it.
Even if there are allies, they might not just be allies. Maybe Monokuma's telling us to investigate that information on our own? Jackie said she could not betray the Future Foundation, but if she were still alive, she definitely would have helped us. No, even her just being with us would have been a big help.
Hmm.
So what should we do?
Damn it.
Well, that's obvious. Get out of here safely. We have to go to that graduation exam, right?
So annoying.
Graduation exam, huh? Really good at taking exams. Well, I guess it's better than other people dying.
Jeez.
Kuma said something about a field trip, right? He's telling us to investigate like we have been.
All right.
I'm gonna do it.
Prepare yourself. Exactly. Make a move.
Like...
I hit the wrong filter there. Yeah, we might be able to learn about something. About Hopeseek Academy. About ourselves. I don't care if we don't know anymore. Just go back to our normal lives. I'm fine.
Hey!
Hey! We can go home with this. This is over, right? We can finally get off this damn island, right? If that's the case, let's all leave this island all by alive then, okay? Nobody else dies!
Of course!
Hell yes! He's right. That's not the time to bemoan how lucky I am. This place really is. What happened to Hopespeak Academy? None of that matters. What's important is, I need to leave this island with the others. Sacrificed so many lives in order to survive just so we could do that. There's no way we'd stop now. But Monokuma should already know that that's what we're thinking. So, why did he say that? We decide on our own whether or not we want to leave. We should already know that we'd never choose to stay.
Hey,
so what are we going to do? We start already? But what are we even looking for? Do we just have to investigate this weird-ass building?
Even so,
I think we'll be find the answers to all our questions inside this damn building. Oops! Oh, I'll just go on ahead for now.
Whoa!
Hey! You're already going.
Jeez.
Is that any thinking running ahead without being cautious?
Man.
She obviously isn't thinking about anything.
However.
It will be fine. There will no longer be any situations where we must exchange each other's lives.
All right.
But we should do our best as well. Like they say, it is not scary if everyone stops at a green light. Does anyone know what phrase she's talking about? Because I don't. Damn it, Wade. Hey. Okay. Her boot power went over 9,000, damn it. If we stopped at the green light, we'd never reach our goal.
Jeez, you're pathetic.
Kane already took off on her own. I'd be fast if we split up and look around too. Like Sony said, there's no more killing. We don't have to worry about anyone betraying us anymore. Then let's get this over with and go home.
Later.
Go on ahead. See you guys later. Those brief words, Fuyuhiko left the gymnasium.
Excuse me.
I should do my best to obtain a wonderful clue that would be useful to everyone. Now then, please excuse me. Sonya took a deep bow and then let the...
Oh my.
Miss Sonya, please don't leave me. I'll be in danger if I'm left alone. As Suichi chased after Sonya, who had just departed, and left the gymnasium. I should hurry and start too. Just a bit more. A bit more, and it's going to end. I can escape this nightmare and return to my usual peaceful everyday life. Right? One thing we can do is advance toward that hope. Even though I don't understand and that a lot of horrifying things keep happening. For the sake of everyone who couldn't make it this far, definitely gonna go home. Yes! Power overwhelming. Real quick. Just a minute. Alright. Huh? That's weird. This is the hallway I walked through to get to the gymnasium, but it's completely different. Is this Monokuma's doing too? Is he trying to confuse us again? I don't know how long he's doing it, but he keeps doing it over and over again. He's so persistent. But I'm not gonna fall for his trap. There's no way this will make me back down. This hallway, there is a strange feeling to it, no? As if an invisible wall has been erected to limit our movement?
I am concerned.
Is it just me? You and me both, sister. Chat? It's alive! Get some ramen. Present. Ramen! Eat it up, little one. Eat it up, yes. Present. Coconut juice. Present. Coffee. Arr. Looks at it. Present. Coffee. So does no one else see the glitch, or is that just us? Or actually, it should be very clear here. Us as the player. Non-alcoholic wine. You gotta be very careful with toddlers, chat. Newborns especially. A Ricardo baguette. We gotta give the maximum of love. Hardtack of hope. That's a soda. Have you had hope in a soda yet? It tastes carbonated. Natural salt. No idea. Clearly have no idea. Oh, Orizotto? For risotto? All right, small little child, you have been fed to the max. You are now max. Okay. Well, I guess this cuts down on the art assets. Welcome to dojo. Hey. Is this a dojo? It's full of strange things that make me think there's no way we're inside a school. Perhaps it's a mistake to expect the inside of this building to make sense. Or just anything in this entire, like, situation. What is this? Is this a manga? The title is Manga for Morons, A History of Hostpeak Academy by Monokuma. Why is a manga with such a suspicious-looking title laying out on the open like this? You know, Hajime, you have, like, some of the strangest, like, thought processes in this game that are, like, they will jump the shark, or you'll have, like, a logic-based, like, somehow wraparound, or you'll actually say something smart, but then occasionally you just darn. I don't get it. Let's start with history first.
Hey,
Reading manga is the third best way to learn about history. Then what's the first, you ask? That depends on the person. So just as I thought, Monokuma made this. It totally explains how suspicious he looks. I really want to just ignore it, but there's no way I can do that. Fine, I'll look at it. Better not be a nudie manga. Really flat and hard as rock, but densely packed in nutrients and vitamins. Use military rations up until after the Second World War. You're meant to eat them with water or coffee.
Oh, cool.
So they're tooth crackers. That's what we refer to them here in Washington. Picked up the manga off the floor and started flipping through the pages. Plot was contrived, the characters were blah and callous. The main villain was overly rote and generic. But the art was good though. Yeah. I'd give it a 4 out of 10. Yeah. The introduction to Hope Speak Academy's history is narrated by the cutesy character on the cover. The story begins with an introduction to Hope Speak Academy. Hope Speak Academy is a government-funded school of privilege where only the most talented high school students can hope to attend. Built to raise hope in the nation's future, many of its alumni are key leaders of various industries. Few students are chosen through a scouting process, but the ones who scout them are Hope Speak Academy's teachers, who serve as both educators and researchers of talent. Hope Speak Academy isn't just a school for talent, it is also a school for researching talent as well. Understanding how you are so good at the luck. However, for the past few years, Hope Speak Academy has been suffering from a decline in funding. Which is really weird when you think about it. If this persists, the Academy believes they will not be able to make progress with their research of talent. They decided to implement a new system. A killing game. Or the Reserve Department. Unlike the main department who scouts for students, the Reserve Department utilizes a general entrance exam. Okay. Normal faculty were hired and placed in charge of looking after the Reserve Department. Expenses and exam fees for the Reserve Department are quite high compared to the most high schools. Nevertheless, Hope Speak Academy received an endless stream of applicants. Hope Speak Academy was now available to talentless commoners. People who only cared about the brand. With this, Hope Speak Academy managed to amass sizable funds and began further research of talent. To create Hope Speak Academy's earnest wish, a true genius who would become mankind's hope. But just when they thought everything was going well, an unprecedented incident occurred. The incident that triggered the tragedy, the biggest, most awful, and most tragic event in human history. Which we really still don't know because Monokuma and or Junko tried to swing the idea that the entirety of the world was basically in shambles, right? Fallout had occurred. And or New Vegas. We don't even know that's true. Game of Tech, evening, morning. Hope you're having a good day. That's right. It was a tragedy of Hope Speak Academy. Hope Speak Academy was crippled by this incident and was forced to shut down without accomplishing anything. The end. Huh. The ending was so sudden, like a manga that suddenly canceled in the middle of a run. Plus, these phrases mentioned at the end of the manga. These names are so melodramatic. There's no way these incidents really happened, right? This manga only mentions the name, so I don't really know the details, but no, it'd just be a waste of time to wonder about things that don't make sense. More importantly, learn something because of this manga. I've learned that Monokuma can't actually write a manga. The Reserve Department. That department was only built to collect money. I was one of those Reserve Corps students, right?
But hold on.
That's weird. Here again.
Shing!
The thing that's weird is you, of course. Huh?
Hey!
Why did you forget that you were part of the Reserve Department? The Future Foundation only took away your school life memories, right? But you should have known even before you entered that you had no talent, right? So, I think it's weird that you actually forgot something like that, too. What do you want me to say?
By the way,
based on my assumption, the Future Foundation must have wanted to hide the fact that you were one of those reserves core students.
I got it!
Or you willingly sealed those memories yourself. Huh? You wanted to be confident in yourself, so you wanted to forget everything that embarrassed you. You know, when humans experience trauma, sometimes they erase their memory of what happened.
So what, becoming here destroyed my own memories?
It happens pretty often. Not that I know anything about that, though.
Are you saying it's my fault I forgot? That's not it.
Come on!
When things get inconvenient, you always get angry and try to brush it off. Well, that's expected of a reserve course student.
Damn it! What the heck? Wait, how did... I got a truth baller for that? Okay? That feels like such a weird truth bullet to get. Hey, Soda.
What's going on?
In this hallway. It's kind of creepy. I can't go to places that I should be able to go to. Like some rules is being enforced for no reason. It's like there's an invisible wall or something. So they can't see the weird glitchy glitches. Interesting. Did we come out of 5A? No, it's always changing. Again, chat, for once, I didn't break the game. Hey there, you're playing a great game. Ah, Kings, morning. Hope you're having a good day. This is another manga. It's laying on top of the desk. This one is... Manga for Morons, A Tragedy of Hopespeak Academy. Huh. Wasn't The Tragedy of Hopespeak Academy mentioned in that other manga too? Why Hopespeak Academy went bankrupt and it was a trigger? If I read this manga, will I be able to learn a little more about that incident? Hopefully it's not as vague as the last game.
I took the manga from the desk and started to flip through the pages to see what I could learn about the event known as the Tragedy of Hopespeak Academy. Apparently, violence. The story made heavy use of outdated stylized drawings depicting characters solving mysteries. What's written here is, as the name suggests, the Tragedy of Hopespeak Academy occurred at Hopespeak Academy.
Gosh, I thought the tragedy actually occurred in, you know, like, Texas. Not Hopespeak Academy. Naturally, the key player in that event was a student named Izuru Kamakura. Izuru was a genius known as a symbol of hope. Hopespeak Academy used all their resources to develop him. He was a robot? Supposedly, Izuru was a genius among geniuses and possessed various talents. Wielding superior talent for the hope of mankind, the Academy referred to Izuru as the ultimate hope. Okay. To protect such rare talent, the Academy completely concealed all evidence of his origins and identity. Because of that, most of the students at the Academy were completely unaware. Izuru, who was known as the symbol of hope, was responsible for a horrible incident. So he committed tragedy so that he could be hope? 13 students of Hopespeak Academy Student Council, among the Academy's best and brightest, were brutally murdered. However, the incident did not end there. The Academy tried to protect Uzura's superior talent and concealed the incident as though it never happened. That's... How could you view him as hope if he's creating despair? More to the point, did Izuru go and find Junko? Or did he make Junko? Because her idea of despair is more as in, he's bored, right? Kind of like one of those, you know how you have like a serial killer? Serial killer has fans and or stands, and then they try to groom one of them. It's such a weird but great series. However, certain student began working in secret to use that incident to their advantage. That student uncovered what the academy did, and by making that knowledge public, took the buyers of reserve course students who had long been dissatisfied with how they've been treated. And the uprising began. Okay, hold on. What? Look, we played Danganronpa 1, and it seemed a little weird, right? But this almost is like they rose up because they were shit on the whole time. And that heralded Host Peak Academy's destruction. So they left? Asked for a refund? Bugged out? Eventually, that incident would lead to that horrifying, devastating incident. The incident that would be known as the, yeah. With a heavy sigh, I closed the manga. Somehow, I just imagine Hajime being like, he's better writing. Am I supposed to believe this? There's no way 13 people were killed at Host Peak Academy. Well, I mean, there is. What irony for a genius known as the Ultimate Hope to cause such a gruesome incident. A talent like that is too regale for society. It's like trying to buy juice with a bar of gold. You should be lucky that you're incompetent. Damn it. He always has to lead up to something offensive. He seriously pisses me off. But Ultimate Hope? Nagato mentioned that before, too. But it looks like it means something completely different here. What Nagato said was the true meaning of hope. You know, it'd be kind of cool is if, even though we're the reserve, that's how they covered it up. Like, turning Izaru, aka Hajime, into a reserve student. Which then means that we might have forgotten that we are a serial killer. Because let's be fair, if you kill more than one person, yeah. But for Izuru, hope simply means talent. More importantly, a genius who possesses various talents? I wish they'd given me one of those talents so I didn't have to be in the reserve department. That's right, the reserve department. Here, it's said that the reserve corps students in the reserve department began uprising. They have got to stop reissuing the same words. Like, you gotta find synonyms, buddy, please. And what about me? Was I a participant too?
You were the leader.
Izuru? Serial killer. Is he? No, that's not possible. There's no way. I have no reason to do something like that.
Truth bullet obtained. Shitty manga. Hey.
Anyway, I've learned about the tragedy. Is a far worse incident, right? Yeah, what kind of incident was it? Izuru? Pronunciation? Izzy. And who's this other student that isn't Izuru? A certain student who secretly used the incident to their advantage? Junko, perhaps? Totally got... See, this is what happens when you let rich kids be rich. You knock that money out and they'll have something to do, namely getting a job, worrying about finances, like everybody else in the world. Perfectly fine. That'll keep her busy. Who is that? This incident is really messed up, but all it's doing is raising more questions. The mysteries just keep piling up. See, I'm still thinking, somehow Junko is a virus, which could be what our shady character was talking about on the ship, is somehow he scanned Junko's brain, put that into a matrix-like construct. Maybe the Future Foundation just decided to take all the best and brightest and brain scan them, put them into this, and then this could just be all research that this is how they figure out what's going on. Which then begs the question, is Danganronpa 1 also the same thing? Is that all just a construct as well? Or was that just the events slightly before Danganronpa 2? And then the question becomes is, who would be stupid enough to actually, you know, brain scan Junko? Hang on, let me go grab a thermal real quick. Because let's be fair here, chat. There's only one simp in this, this video game. That's Soda. You can't have two simps in one game. There's a rule, okay? And there's a second simp because he's just being a hardcore fan of despair. Then we got ourselves a problem here. Naturally. What the hell is with this room? It's freaking cold in here. It's like I'm in a freezer or something. But just staying still, I might end up freezing to death. I should hurry up and investigate so I can get out of here already. Hello.
I've been found.
That should really be the ultimate simp. Probably. There's another manga just laying around here. This time the title is Manga for Morons, the biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history. I knew it. The next one will be obviously about this. Okay. Huh. Just what was that incident really all about? Might turn out to be something lame. Well, I don't want to spoil it for you, chat. Okay. And I know some of you played this game, but I don't want to spoil it. I haven't played this game, but I'm pretty sure the most awful event, the biggest, most awful, most tragic human event in human history, he ran out of toilet paper. Everybody making a mad dash of toilet paper, and I'm sorry, we're just out of it. You're gonna have to use leaks. All there is to it. I flipped through the pages of the manga and hoped that it was right. I know. Actually, it is kind of sad. Moving forward, any movie that does not have any movie story or game that does not have a situation where like the TP has been sold out and it's like an apocalyptic event, you gotta call bull. That's just how that works. Sorry about creepily drawn characters who get involved in such horrifying incidents. Incident known as the Is it? I feel like at this point, like by time, like when you're playing Danganronpa 2, right? The biggest, most awful, most tragic event in human history is just a joke, right? When we get to V3 and then Despair Girls, like down the road, if they keep referencing that without actually explaining really what it is in detail, it's just gonna be like a gag. Gotta be. Like at that point, somebody's pulling your chain. Is this drawn so grotesquely because the incident itself is that grotesque? Anyway, the beginning of this creepy manga starts with this sentence. Simply the trigger. At first, the uprising by the Reserve Corps that triggered the tragedy was initially hoped to be resolved quickly. They used stun batons. It was not effective. The situation continued to escalate to dangerous extremes. The movement started spreading all over the internet and fostered a thriving online community. The community was not limited to students and people of various races and nations and joining in. Stockpile! The movement was not confined to the internet. It began spreading and eroding the real world. When the movement started, it was indistinguishable from any other demonstration inspired by social unrest. But as it spread across the world, certain abnormalities soon came to light. By then, it was too late. The ends and the means had vanished. The wanton destruction became their only goal. The strong butchered the weak. The weak killed the weakest among them. And soon, the weak foreign factions brutally murdered the strong. I mean, at least it does sound like they're getting smarter. As the violence and death continued to spread, the shock of their actions began to disappear. As if the era was regressing to more uncivilized times, when senseless deaths were the norm. Media was oversaturated with deaths to the point where people would watch them while enjoying a meal. By the time the world realized what it had become, it was too late to stop what had happened.
Okay, so I'm starting to believe that the Future Foundation is an arc.
A arc of the best and brightest who have been brain scanned and or pushed into the Matrix, right? We're now connected to tubes and somebody who worships or idolizes